just used to leave. And everyone.
Hello, welcome to We Love LA, where this is our substation for health, wealth, and success. And thank you for tuning in tonight. My name is Sheena, and I am your host. I am also the creator of this platform where talking about being healthy, how being wealthy and bringing more success into your life is the conversations. And so first and foremost, I do not own the rights to the music that is playing in the background. So I have Pharrell playing Freedom. It is Black History Month, and so we're celebrating this Black History celebration, not just for the month of February, but it is a celebration in American history all year round, just as much as we have other diversifications of cultures that is being honored for their history and their lineage, and some of the cultures and the diversity that they brought to this country, because America is the melting pot, and America was always known for that American dream, where you come, you purchase land, you are able to provide for your family and be able to pass down a legacy. And so that American dream originally was just for a certain group of people, people who migrated from other countries and, you know, made names for themselves. And a lot of the minority people were just kind of pushed out of having those abilities to have that American dream. And so we want to talk about the American dream. First and foremost, of course, today is President's Day. So again, talking about that American dream. And yesterday we did have Valentine's Day, which is, you know, a nice little made up day for marketing. So the American dream, you know, we have, there's, I believe, a month for Latino History Month. Also, there's other different cultures and diversities of cultures that we have here in this country. Hello, welcome to We Love LA. And so, hey, Angel, it's been a long time. Hope that you are doing well. But speaking in regards to Black History Month, I like to just acknowledge some of our pioneers that have been probably not acknowledged before, or a lot of people may not know about the persons in our past and things like that. But I wanted to talk about this one particular person. His name was Fredrick K C Price, and he was a televangelist at one of a popular church here in Los Angeles, California, which is called the Crenshaw Christian Center. Now, I never had attended the church, but I do remember growing up as a kid. My grandmother and my aunt, they would faithfully watch his sermons every Sunday. And so I really, really, really know just remembering seeing him every Sunday. Hello, hello, welcome to We Love LA. Thank you for tuning in. So it shows that Mr. Price, or Reverend Price, he was actually born January 3rd of 1932. And so literally he's just two years older than my grandmother, but he just recently passed this past Friday. And he was born here in Santa Monica, California, and he passed away at the age of 89 in Torrance. And he had made a really, really, really big impact on the community. He has made a really big impact on just being televised for, you know, sharing the mission on how we are supposed to be living our lives. You know, everything that we might think about the Bible is just following some rules and some strict commands, but there are some real stories in the Bible that really talk about and focus on living an abundant life, living a wealthy life. And you know, having your health is very important, because a person who live an unhealthy life is not living an abundant life. Now, I'm not going to get biblical on anybody, and just for the discretion of this conversation tonight, I am not trying to convince anyone to changing their religion or saying that one religion is better than the other. I'm only just strictly using these biblical examples to how it apply into everyday life. And so just a lot of analogies and examples on some of the meanings that they mean. And so this past Sunday, I was invited to a sermon, which the pastor was an attendee to the Crenshaw Christian Center. And part of her message that, you know, she was speaking in regards to was, you know, when you're being baptized, you are changing your life. You are starting anew. And the message that I kind of got from that was, it's not necessarily like in order, you know, it's not just about being baptized to be good, but it was more about anything that you want to do in life. If you want to lose weight, you have to change your mindset and you have to become anew. If you have any other kind of bad habits, you have to acknowledge the fact that I have this bad habit going on and I need to change it. And in order to change it, you have to be able to recognize what it is and create a plan for you to make that change in your life. And so in order for you to be a better athlete, hi, hello, welcome to WeluvLa. In order to be a better athlete, you have to decide that you want to train hard. In order to save more money, you have to make that decision, hey, I need to save more money. Or, you know, I transitioning to where I might want to be a mother or a wife one day, you can't live the same life that you used to live. So it's all about the lifestyle. And that's the message that I had got from being born again and being baptized. Is not just necessarily just in biblical terms, but it is necessary in every aspect of your life. In order for you to become better, to become anew, you have to cleanse yourself of the old habits. And so just bringing up Fredrick Price, which was the minister for the Crenshaw Christian Center years ago, just wanted to give a shout out to all of the members who were a fan and who were faithful to his preachings, and the fact that his messages have gone a long way into people who was raised on his teachings, and being able to hear his legacy still being taught in today's in present times. And so just wanted to say thank you for that. Also, this is probably the first video that I've actually done that had some kind of biblical message. Now, once again, part of the discretion, I am not speaking in regards to religion, but just the Bible have some stories that actually have some really good references as analogies in today's time and in everything that we do. So this is the only part of what I am only mentioning in regards to the Bible, because I just want to respect everybody who may or may not follow or have other beliefs. But again, so I just want to thank everybody for being here. So I just wanted to give that small message. Also, yesterday we had our Valentine's, so I'm not for sure if anybody had an amazing day yesterday, any excitement, or if you were not celebrating with anybody, you know, did you have some self-love for yourself? And so that's also going to be another thing, just being able to understand that you are important and that loving yourself is always going to be number one. Now, to kind of revert it into biblical, Number one is yourself. You have to put yourself first. And then in your relationship, your partner is next, then your kids. But your partner is supposed to lead you into the right path of doing things the right way. Or, let's not say right or wrong, but doing things morally great. So, if anybody have had any wonderful partnerships that's happened yesterday, had any love relationships with themselves, that's always going to be great and amazing, having that celebration with life. Now, again, like how I had mentioned, Black History Month is should be celebrated every day of the year, just as much as any other religion and national appreciations. Valentine is also another day that should just be a day that's appreciated throughout the whole year, right along with Mother's Day and right along with Father's Day. So that's just my own personal opinion. But that was just a great way for making sure that we are appreciating ourselves and loving ourselves, because in order for us to love others, we have to love ourselves first. So it's just a small portion for Valentine. And then President's Day, well, talking politics and religion is really a touchy subject. And like I always mention, there's the discretion, not saying who is better and what is better than another. It is just based off of what kind of would make sense into what the situation is. And so with President's Day, my only speech I am going to speak on for President's Day is that this should be a national holiday for everything to be closed. And so, just for people to acknowledge and understand their political party and what they are about and how they are for the people. So my best suggestion in regard to the whole President's Day is for us to be educated again on what is the purpose of the political party, what is the purpose of our government system, and how they are for the people, and what do they do for us. You know, I hear a lot of people, they may complain saying that the government's supposed to do for us. The government, they supposed to have our best interest. And technically, I mean, why would you want to put your life in somebody else's hands when you should have control of your own life? The only control that should be there is making sure that the moral rules are being abided by to make sure that you don't lose your freedom, pay your taxes, and don't do anything wrong where you are losing your freedom. And so understanding the laws and understanding the rules to making sure that you don't lose that, because at the end of the day, we talk about being healthy, being wealthy, and making sure that we are succeeding in every area in our lives. And so everything is always about education. Education is very important, but it's not just education alone. It's always implementing said education, said information. So knowledge is power, but you got to act upon it and represent what you had learned. A lot of people may be afraid to fail or don't fully understand, but sometimes it is best for you to learn and understand through experience as well. Now, if you have a mentor or someone who can show you the ropes and let you know that I've already had experience, whatever situation, to the point where they can guide you to understand and you can see it from their point of view to where you don't have to make those same mistakes. And so that's always going to be important as well. And so didn't want to take too much of everybody's time. Just wanted to drop a couple of golden nuggets on everybody's timeline today. So I talk about a bunch of random things, some things that are just on the top of my mind or they may be on my heart. And if there's any type of topic that you would like for me to discuss, I am always open to discussing whatever it is. I may not know off the top of my head, but I could do my research, ask some people who I might know who had experienced those things, or do a little bit of research, and then we can discuss them together. And so I would be glad to discuss any of those things that you may be interested in. Please feel free to send me a nice little DM, or you can send me an email at info@weluvla. That's WELUVLA.LA. And I can most definitely have your questions to be broadcast on our live. And then also, if you like the randomness that I do talk about and might just be curious to know a little bit more on exactly what I do, double tap on a video and subscribe to my YouTube channel at Where Are We Going Now, She. And so there's going to be more content that will be coming out soon. I am live every Monday at 7:30 Pacific Standard Time. And for more information in regards to asset preservations, you want to understand how to grow and protect your money, whatever it is that is the most important thing to you in regards to your money and in regards to your health, feel free to contact me, send me a DM and or an email, and I can most definitely get back to you to see who I can refer you to. That is part of my mission, is to drop golden nuggets, share as much information as possible, because again, it is the implementation of the knowledge and being fully aware that we should be in control of our lives. We have to get up every day and figure out how we are going to make an income to be able to sustain our lifestyle. It is up to us how we're going to eat. It is up to us how we're going to take care of our families. And so I am a big advocate on making sure that I can add some type of value into your life to where you can be more independent and take care of yourself and not having to depend on somebody else. Because my biggest thing is, if we give the power over to someone else to feed us, then we can most definitely be giving them that power to starve us. And so in all of that, I say thank you very much for tuning in to We Love LA, and have a good night.
Take me to your river.